Hi, I'm Smriti from Simply Crafted, and I'm doing some craft sessions to bring in some positivity.
It will be a very, very entertaining session, so do watch it till the end.
And all the products that I have used, I have linked them below for your convenience. So have fun, stay tuned, and like and subscribe, please. Bye.
So today we'll be talking about a scoring board and what is this. But before I start doing this, let me show you today's inspiration. I've made a small little rosette for you, and now all of you will say, ma'am, ye to kitna simple hai, you know. And I agree, ye bahut simple hai. But still, there is a way of even simplifying it further. Then there is this small little envelope that I have made, and this flower is a, I'm sure all of you have such punches, right? So this flower is nothing but just a punched flower. Now when we open the envelope, we have a small little card here. Can you see the card? Is it cute? Is it nice? But how do we actually do all this professionally so that our crease is very clean, our cuts are very nice? How do we do this? How do we make an envelope at home and make sure that it comes out perfect? How do we make a rosette at home very easily? All this we will talk about today. So for this today, I will be educating you about a scoring board. All right. Now, yeah, I think you can see the scoring board very well. Okay. So this is the scoring board. Basically, iske andar sabke andar lines hui hui hain. Aur jaise hamara ek scale hota hai, like we have a scale, and it has all the markings, centimeters, inches, everything. Exactly like this, you have a scale over here, okay? So that you can measure your papers. Now, if I have to make a card, you will first, let's say I have to make a card which is 3 inches by 3 inches. What will you do? You will take a scale, you will take a pencil, and then you will mark 3 inches here and 3 inches here, and then make a line and then fold it, right? That is what we will do. But when I have a scoring board, for me it is as simple as this, that I've just cut my paper, I will align it with the corners, and this is what, 6.5. 6.5 means 3 1/4, and that is it. And just fold the mountain and my card is ready. But can you see the clean notch that we have over here? The corner is completely clean. All right, so that is how a scoring board makes it very easy for us to do work. Another thing is, this scoring board has a small flap behind this, which helps us to understand how can we make an envelope. So hame yaad karne ki zarurat nahi padti, we don't have to remember, or we don't have to calculate that, okay, now this is my measurement, what is the size of the paper that I should cut. It is very easily written over here. So for this particular card, which is a little less than 3.5 by 3.5, I just have to take a paper which is 6 by 6, and I have to scale mark at 3 inches, and if I follow this properly, I'll be able to make my envelope very easily. So come, let's see how are we making it. Okay, so I'm going to align this over here. Over here it says 6x6 paper. So let's see whether I have a 6x6 paper. See, it is a 6x6 paper. The measurements are also easily done. Align it. It says scale mark at 3 inches. So I just have to place this over here at 3, because I have a scale over here as well. Align this, hold my paper, and just make a scoring line. This is called a scoring line. That is why this is called a scoreboard, because these are all called scoring lines. Turn it around, align it again, and all four sides, all I have to do is just keep aligning and just keep scoring. All four sides scored. Can everybody see? Give me a thumbs up if everybody has understood this. Good, great. Now, to make an envelope, can everybody see this picture? to make an envelope, we need to cut these corners, right? So I will take a scissors and I will cut these corners. But you know, there is a special tool for me which makes my life very easy. This is a punch. It's called a notch punch. All I have to do is align it and cut it. See? So nicely it has given me this cut. So these are my professional tools which I use to make all the professional items that I make. Is this clear so far? Everybody give me a thumbs up if it is clear. Okay, great. So now that we have done this, when we make a scoring line, ek jagah there is a depression, the other side you will see a mountain. So always fold the mountain. Fold the mountain. And this is a magic tool for me when it comes to paper craft, because it is very easy for me to press it down. So just fold the mountain and press it down. Fold the mountain and press it down. So now that all the folding is done, if I will paste this over this, my envelope is ready. Can you see how easy this was? All because of one scoring board. So now what am I going to do? Now I have a double-sided tape. This again, a very important tool for paper crafters. This is, yes, you can use glue for it also, but as I said, it is a very important tool for paper crafters. Why am I saying this? It's because when I am working on an order, I don't have time for the glue to dry. I have to do it quickly, right? You sitting at home, of course you can do it because you are doing for fun, right? My voice is, can you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So now that we've applied, okay, then I'll talk slowly. Now that I've applied my double-sided tape, I'm going to press it down further with this so that there are no bubbles. Remove the tape. So can you see how easily I made this envelope? So again, I will show it to you. Just align it over here. This is a 6x6 paper, and a 6x6 paper tells me to the scale mark is 3 inches. I'm just going to put it over here and score. I will score all 4 sides. Now. So now to cut these corners, like I told you earlier, you can take a scissors and cut it, okay? But if you have a notch cutter, I can just place it over the notch and cut it. It just makes my life easy because the cut is very clean. Here. Okay, and like I told you earlier, when we make a scoring line, you have depression on one side, or maybe you've studied valleys and mountains, right? So your valley always goes inside. This is sort of a valley and this is a mountain. So you always fold the mountain, okay? Fold the mountain and then take your bone folder and make sure that you press it really well so that it stays in its place. Here. Now to stick it, we will apply tape on 2 sides and apply it. And yes, you can always use glue also. No problem in that. Everybody's clear how we make this? So just press it down, make sure all the bubbles. You know, whenever you are using a double-sided tape, many people do not understand this or do not take care about this. But there are always bubbles between the tape and the paper. So to make sure that it sticks properly, always press it down very firmly so that there are no bubbles between the tape and the paper. Okay? Now press this down and one by one, you can fold in the wings. Yeah, another envelope is ready. Now another thing which I can show you from with this notch is that it has a corner punch on the other side. It has a notch creator on one side. It has a corner punch on the other side. Now what is a corner punch? When you have a corner like this and you just want to round it off, like yesterday I showed you when we were doing our pencil box, you can just put it inside, align it with the corners, press it and see. It's a very sweet little corner that has cut. Okay?
So we had a class yesterday.
Day before yesterday. I'm sorry. My mistake. Okay? So this is how we make a envelope. Okay. So let's keep this aside. Let's keep this card aside. We've already made all these things. We will embellish them a little later. Now, I was talking about this. How easily you can make this. Now for me, making this rosette is very simple and easy. How? I just take my scoring board, I align my paper on the top and on the side, and at every half an inch, I just start scoring. That is all that I need to do. Simple, no measurements, nothing. This is done. Since I'm making a multicolored rosette, I have three colors. There, I'm done. Now, just start folding. Okay, press it. Now let's just join them together. This one here. This one here. So let's just put a tape here. press so that you remove all the bubbles. And just press it here. So I'm just going to cut this edge.
I'm using a scale.
Okay, very good. The best thing about creativity is that it allows us to be resourceful. So even though we do not have certain products, we should not get demotivated and we should just work with what we have. Okay, done. Now just bring it all together and we have this rosette ready. Fine. So let me just take out something. Okay, let me just take this out. What should I use now? I can use a double-sided tape. Whenever you're working with double-sided tape, make sure that you are always working with two scissors. Because badi jaldi ek scissors kharab ho jati hai. Another one also. There. So just put it together, hold it, take out all the tapes. You can also use glue gun if you want and just press it together. And on the other side again. So you can make small and big rosettes to, you know, put on your cards, on your envelopes or on your tags. Best wishes, congratulations, happy birthday tags, whatever you want to make. Okay, you can beautify it further if you have some cutouts, you know, you can put it, you can put, another thing, oh yes, there is another thing which I wanted to show you. Here, I wanted to show you how did I do this. Can you see this circle which I just used? So there is a circle over here, there is a rectangle paper over here, and there is a printed flower over here. Now this, right now, since it's a lockdown, you can always cut out from magazines, you know, from various places if you have floral things. But you also get such motif sheets available in the market, okay, where you can just cut these out and you can use them, okay. So I have a couple of these or many already cut ke rakhe hue hain, you know. So in this box I always have something or the other cut out, some die cuts or something, some flowers made. So accordingly I can just take out certain things and just make something. Okay, so here I have inspire, here I have a flower. So just make a little arrangement and that is it. You are done. Or maybe this bird will look better. Wait. Let's make it simple. We have a pink flower, we have a blue flower, and we have inspire written over here. And this is so sweet, isn't it? So let's just put this all together and make one particular layout. Okay, I think I'm done. I like this. So I will just put this together. Okay. So. So I have inspire written over here. You could probably write happy birthday or best wishes. Oh, I already have a double-sided tape behind inspire. So I will just put inspire over here. Take out some embellishments. Probably put two embellishments here. And there you go. Isn't this cute? So this is how you can create anything, you see. There is no hard and fast rule in creative world. Okay, let's see what else can we make. Since we had our bases ready, what do you want me to show you next? Should I make a card for you? Okay, see, now this was a small piece of card that I had already cut, and these were some pieces which I had already cut. Let me just take few of these and just see what can I create.
Ma'am, can we also use cellotape for craft?
Yes, you can use cellotape for craft. You can use anything for craft. Okay, this one says season's greeting. Let's do season's greeting this time. Okay. I think this is cute. We can make this. This is so sweet. Okay, let's do this. So, okay, now this was flat. हमने सीधा फेविकॉल से चिपका दिया. अब अगर हमें थोड़ी डायमेंशन देनी है तो हम हमेशा डबल साइडेड टेप का यूज करते हैं सो दैट इट गिव्स अस अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ रेज्ड प्लेटफॉर्म. तो जिससे हमारे प्रोजेक्ट में कुछ डायमेंशन ही आ जाती है. So here we are going to put it down and then now I see, can you see there is a little dimension now? अब मैं चाहूँ तो मैं बर्ड को भी थोड़ा सा और ऊपर उठा के लगा सकती हूँ। देखो एक छोटी सी कटोरी लगाने से कितना फर्क पड़ जाता है। Okay, how is this? Nice? अच्छा, while doing paper craft, no, हमेशा फेविकॉल कम लगाना चाहिए, पता है? बहुत ज्यादा नहीं लगाना चाहिए। अगर कम कम लगाओगे then it will instantly dry and it will work instantly. Okay, a flower on flower, will that help? Yes, that will also look good. So here is my envelope. It is ready and I can put any of these cards inside it. ठीक है? So this is done. अच्छा, let me show you a card. What do you think about this? Do you think can we make a nice card with this, with these strips? So like you have punches like this. I was saying, can you make cards with this? These papers which we throw away, जो बच जाते हैं हमारे पास, इसका हम क्या करें? So इसका हम, जैसे हमारे पास punches होते हैं, एक तो हम इन सबके flowers cut out करके ऐसे box में रख सकते हैं, that is what I do. मैं हमेशा ऐसे box में छोटे 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 छोटा सामान काट के रखती हूँ, तो जब मुझे कुछ बनाना होता है फिर मैं ये पिटारे को खोलती हूँ और मैं फटाफट बनाना शुरू कर देती हूँ. ठीक है? So when yes, craft का पिटारा. Okay, but there are other ways also. So like you have these punches, I also have some big punches. This is just to cut out a circle. ये जो हमने circle काट के रखे हुए, ये circle इस punch से कट जाता है straight away. Okay, then I have border punches also to create borders. Now let me show you a very simple way of creating. Let's say, first just let me see the, because it's looking like a jhanda actually. But anyways, और आई थिंक आई शुड पुट दिस ऑन टॉप. हाँ, मे बी दिस ऑन टॉप. ठीक है, सो लेट्स से आई टेक अ बॉर्डर पंच एंड वेरी नाइस, वेरी वेरी नाइस, वेरी गुड. सो सी, दिस इज अ बॉर्डर पंच. All I have to do is just put the paper inside it, align it, and cut it. It gives me a nice border. Okay, थोड़ा सा खराब कर दिया मैंने, टेढ़ा मेढ़ा कर दिया. Repeat again, what are you asking me? Amazon. Today when I finish my class again, I will put everything on the YouTube and I will even put the links so you can take it from there, okay? If you follow the link, then you will not buy the wrong product. Can you see? Such a beautiful border. Okay, now that we've done with our border punches, we've finished. Let me just align it together and just stick it. I'm honestly right now using just the normal chart paper jo humko we get it from the market. This is about 170 GSM. But generally for professional card making, scrapbook making, I use 300 GSM paper.
Mom, this is beautiful.
Thank you. And see, we did not even do anything much. It was so simple. Nice.
Mom, like I have also made a box. Like I use like these small boxes to keep my like beads, stars, and all the things I have.
Right. Yeah, they come in very handy.
Yeah. Like my paint box gets over, so I take it for keeping something. Like
yes.
If it's for plastic, it's of plastic.
Okay, now look at this. Isn't this coming out really pretty? Isme kya likhe? True love, soulmate, birds, lovebirds, dream big. Dream big. Dream big is a good one. Yes, one should dream big in life.
Dream big.
Dream big.
Dream big.
And peace. We need peace in today's world, hai na? Let's put peace. Okay, now let's put all this together. So, we'll put this here. I will put this here. Somebody is not on mute. Shweta, Mundra, you need to put yourself on mute. Abhishree, if I'm not wrong, right?
Pretty
thick. No, not this. Seedha isse cover karte hain. लेकिन ना इसको हम किसी के ऊपर डालते हैं. सी दिस पिटारा हैज सो मेनी थिंग्स.
camera was left in the call, ma'am.
Who was left in the call?
I was just left for 1 minute.
That's okay. You did not miss anything. This is something which I'm just repeating. So, don't worry, bachcha. So this time we have double color sequence, one pink and one green. And we are done. Look at this. How pretty is this?
Wow.
Hai na? Simple scraps se. Something which we will throw. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, sweetheart. Okay. Nice. What else can I make? और क्या बना के दिखाऊं? अच्छा देखो एक और चीज है. So यहाँ पे तो we have just made all these flowers and envelopes and all. ठीक है? Now sometimes like as I was telling you, I use a thicker paper for making my cards. I use 300 GSM. But sometimes market में 300 GSM नहीं मिलता तो क्या करेंगे? Then what we will do is probably cut another card little smaller and then paste it. So, kyunki ye double layering ho jati hai, so then this becomes nice and sturdy. So, this is a very good tip. Okay. So, I can do it like here I can paste it on top and then create an arrangement. Here I can put it inside. I can also do some stamping over here and then just make the arrangement outside. Okay. So, when I'm doing this, tab mujhe, this is a very important tool at that point of time because it helps me press it down really well. So I'm just going to apply some Fevicol, and again, always remember little Fevicol is what you are looking at. Too much daloge na, wo hamesha phisalta rahega. Thoda daloge, wo bahut achhe se immediately chipkega. Yeah. Now press it down. It makes sure that your Fevicol spreads evenly and it pastes really well. See, can you see this? All of a sudden simple card tha hamara, but now we have a border and now we can work on this. Best wishes again. And इस बार ही bird use करते हैं यार इतनी सारी birds हैं मेरे पास. Just see, just one simple bird, and so beautiful this is looking, है ना? कोई तो हाँ बोलो.
Let's stop. It's looking beautiful.
Thank you.
Everyone is on mute.
Yes, I know everyone is on mute.
Beautiful.
Thank you. Okay, I think I'll... I can't see you. Your camera is off, Monica ji.
Okay.
Your camera is not on.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
See? How can you see? I can't see.
Ma'am? You're
ma'am, we can see. Ma'am, we can see what? Ma'am?
Are you, I'm not being able to
see. Can I show you something I made?
Yes, please show.
Ma'am, this is a flower from quilling.
Okay. You know quilling? That is so nice.
Yes, ma'am. I know it. I can make a bit of
ma'am, you have so many cards.
Yes. And as always, embellishment ke bina to mera koi card banta hi nahi hai. सो कहीं ना कहीं तो लगाना ही होता है. आई ऑलवेज हैव टू पुट इट समवेयर.
आई हैव केप्ट माय थिंग्स इन दिस टाइप काइंड ऑफ बॉक्स व्हिच यू आर यूजिंग.
Great minds think likewise, right? Okay, ready. Okay.